Right now, I'm in Delhi. Kuwait Airlines, it's from Delhi to Kuwait, Kuwait to Istanbul, and it's a round trip. Departure time was around 3 a.m. So the flight got delayed for almost 2 hours, and it was very irritating. I was too sleepy. This food looks pretty similar to the old flight food, so I didn't even open it. Guys, we just landed in Sabiha Gombsen International Airport. This airport is basically in Asian part of Istanbul. So basically this airport was named after Sabiha Gombsen. She was the world's first female fighter pilot. She's named into Guinness Book of World Records for that reason. I exchanged around $150. If you are planning to travel Turkey in 2022, then please please try to exchange your dollars to liras rather than euros, and try not to pay anything in euros but only pay in liras. Currency of lira is falling. You know what, you can rent armed goods like pistols, guns in the airport, and you have to return it back to them while departing from Turkey. Shuttle from airport to hotel, so I'm heading from Sabiha Gökçen to Sultan Mehmet. It was raining like anything, and I took a small nap and then started exploring the city in the night. So my plan was to explore Hagia Sophia, that's a mosque, and there is another mosque called the Blue Mosque, which are close to each other, so that was the reason I chose this place. So good night guys, let's explore the city tomorrow. After a quick breakfast, I headed towards Hagia Sophia and the Blue Mosque. Here we go. That is Hagia Sophia on this side, and exactly on the opposite side of Hagia Sophia you can see Blue Mosque. That is also a popular monument. So after Hagia Sophia we will visit Blue Mosque and then we'll go back to hotel. So let's go towards Hagia Sophia now. Hagia Sophia, actually pronounced as Hagia Sophia. It has a great religious and political history. I'm not very good at both of them, so I'll just brief it according to my knowledge. Hagia Sophia was constructed and demolished many times in the past. Hagia Sophia was initially built by Emperor Constantine, who was a Christian. I'm mentioning both the religion and political histories together so it will be easily understandable further. Constantine built Hagia Sophia as a basilica of his Greek church at that time. So this basilica was built with woods. That means the courtroom was built with the woods. It was burned because of the political conflicts that's happening within the family at that time of Byzantine Empire. They reconstructed it, and because of the revolt that's happening within the empire, it got reburned again and again. They tried to fix it. After that, the fixing has become really complicated. Meanwhile, guys, I need to mention one thing, because this is mosque right now. Women must wear headscarf to enter into the mosque. And this is the place where Muslims clean themselves before entering into a mosque. They call it wuzu. As I mentioned earlier, construction has become very complicated after that. It was in such a bad shape that they had to demolish over and over again for two times, and they started reconstructing it at the last. Then they somehow managed to keep it in the shape. So that was pretty much the shape which Hagia Sophia is right now. Then comes Sultanate Muhammad II of Ottoman Empire, and he conquered this whole empire. That is when he turned Hagia Sophia into a mosque. Then he changed interior and exteriors again to his taste, but pretty much the credit goes to Constantine. So finally, Basilica has turned into a worship place, mosque, after Sultanate's conquer. So the mosque in the country of Istanbul has changed to a museum when Republic of Turkey has formed in 1935. So government has decided to keep as a tourist attraction. So let's visit Hagia Sophia. That's a painting of Virgin Mother Mary carrying baby Jesus. So basically you can find mixed culture in this museum still. You can see Christianity and Islamic cultures both together. The paintings on the walls are still intact in many of the places. We'll figure it out further.